Hey guys, and welcome to Neat Video Tutorials. In this tutorial, we're going to walk you through the basic workflow in Neat Video 5. We're going to cover the steps you will be doing in most cases. So if you just start using Neat Video, this tutorial will be the best starting point on your way towards clean and noise-free videos. Let's get started. To achieve the best possible noise reduction, first, we need to inspect this clip to find a frame with large uniform areas showing strong noise. And this frame looks good, as we have quite a bit of noise here, and it also has featureless areas we are looking for. Now we need to add Neat Video. In Premiere Pro, you can find it in the Effects panel. Drag and drop it onto the clip. For more details on where to find Neat Video in different video editing software and how to apply it to the clip, check our quick start guides. Now we need to build a noise profile. Click the Auto Profile button and then check whether this automatically selected area is suitable for profiling or not. A good area should show no details, should be large enough, and contain clearly visible noise that is strongest in that frame. The noise level indicator helps to check that strength. If these conditions are not satisfied, then manually select a better area and click Build Profile to create a new one. Once you're happy with the area, click the Profile Check button. What you want to see here is an absolutely clear image without any noise. The picture itself will look a bit blurry, but don't worry, it just temporarily. If you find noise and artifacts left here, put the noise level slider up and stop as soon as all the noise is removed. If you go too high, the end result will look blurry. For more info on profiling and its adjusting, check out another tutorial which covers exactly that. Check the links below. When you're happy with the profile, go to the Adjust and Preview tab. Instantly, we're getting a picture that has already been filtered. If you click on the picture, you will see the original image. We also have the play button here at the top. Click it and you will see the result in dynamic. This all will give you an idea of how much noise has already been reduced, and you can decide if you're already happy with the result or you would like to do some tuning. To adjust noise reduction, we have temporal and spatial filter settings tabs. The temporal filter works comparing frames around the current one to determine what is noise and what is not. If you increase the radius, you will give the filter more data to work with, and the picture will look cleaner. But this will be at the cost of render time. When you're done adjusting the temporal filter, you can go to the spatial tab if needed. Here we have noise reduction amount and noise level sliders. Noise reduction amount determines how much of the detected noise we want to reduce by the spatial filter. By default, this value is set to 40%. You can push it higher, but be careful. Very high noise reduction amount can make your picture look overprocessed and spoil the details. If you brought this amount to 100%, but there is still some unwanted noise in the video, then try another approach instead. Increase the noise level. This will tell the spatial filter that there is more noise in the video than it was expected. Bring the noise level up until there is no noise in preview. Then adjust noise reduction amount again to find the balance between reducing enough noise and retaining fine details. Again, be careful and don't set these controls too high. We also have the sharpening tool here, and if you enable it, the picture will regain some sharpness. And now let's check the difference in before and after Neat Video. I'll just select a frame inside my viewer. As you can see, the change is tremendous. And once you're happy with the result, click the Apply button. And remember, nothing can be better than trying it yourself. Try profiling, adjusting filter, checking results, adjusting again, and then you will find what kind of picture you like the most and how to get it fast. If you feel like digging deeper into noise reduction, tuning filter settings, flicker reduction, and other advanced tools, watch our advanced workflow tutorial. That's it, guys. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. Please hit subscribe button for more and give it a thumb up. If you have any questions, leave them in comments. We'll be happy to help. And bye for now!